Greetings, my brothers and sisters. We greet you on this perfect Sunday morning. Share the love of Jesus. How much was a joy to think about all that the Lord has done for us and all that He is doing for us. I certainly want to thank God for each and every one of you who felt in your heart would not rob you to come out to celebrate this resurrected Sunday morning. Letting the world know that Jesus is alive and He's well. So I certainly want to say to you, as we greet you this morning, we come to your home by the ways of social media, through Facebook. We want you to know that we're here to give God the glory, to give God the praise for all of the great things that the Lord has done and all that God is doing. One thing you can rest assured, that He's still in the blessing business. You can rest assured that God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish. So we gather one more time to celebrate this resurrected Sunday morning. But as before we move on, let us pray. Most gracious and merciful Fathers, again, that we come before your throne one more time to say thank you. We thank you, God, for your Son, Jesus, who died on Calvary cross, that whosoever believes in you should not perish, but have an everlasting life. We thank you, God, because early this morning you dispatched an angel to wake us up and allowed us to see a day that we've never seen before and a day that we'll never see again. We ask one more time, Master, Spirit of a living God, fall fresh upon us. We ask now, God, to look upon those in the hospital, those in the convalescent home. Somebody, God, is standing on the street corner. Somebody don't even know you're in the pardon of their sin. But remind them that all things are possible if we only believe. We ask now, God, to touch those that are in the hospital. We pray, God, that thou will save the unsaved. Stretch out your nail-scarred hand. Set the captive free. We ask now that these and many more blessings be accepted in Jesus' name. We pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Again, I say to you, I greet you this morning in Jesus' joy, and I want you to know that there is a word from the Lord. God allowed us to come together, I believe, just to praise His holy name. Even though we're not within the sanctuary, but the sanctuary, the real sanctuary, is within our hearts. But I thank God for you who felt in your heart would not rob you to come this morning to hear a word from the Lord. If you will, look with me this morning out of St. Luke, the 24th chapter. St. Luke, the 24th chapter, beginning at the 35th verse. St. Luke, the 25th chapter, beginning at the 35th verse, you find these words. And he told them what things were done in the way, and how he knew that them, and he break bread, and as he breaking of the bread. And as thus he spake unto them, Jesus himself stood in the midst of them and said unto them, Peace be unto you. But they were terrified and frightened, and supposing that they had seen a spirit. And he said unto them, Why are ye troubled? Why do thoughts arise in your heart? Behold my hand and my feet, that is I myself. Handle me and see. For spirit has not flesh and bone, as ye see me have. And then he said unto them, supposing that they showed them his hands and his feet, and while they were yet believed not, for the joy he wondered, he said unto them, Have ye any meat? And they gave him a piece of boiled fish and honeycomb. I want you to look at me, if you will, out of the 39th verse. Behold my hands and my feet, that is I myself. Handle me and see, for the spirit has not flesh and bone, as ye have seen me have. And I want to talk to you this morning about to remind you that Jesus is real. I wonder, do anyone out there believe that he is real? We're living in a world and a time now where everyone somehow, somewhere believe that he is not real. So we find here in this Gospel of St. Luke, Jesus had to prove it to his disciples that he's real. We're living in a society where folk got to know that he's real within your life. You have to know that he's real within your walk, within your talk. And as Jesus now, you find early in the same chapter when Jesus appeared to the two men on the road, they said unto them, What are you discussing among yourselves? And they asked him, Are you the only stranger in town? And Jesus wanted to know, what do you mean? So we find the word real mean that actually existed or something occurred, a fact, not an image or a suppose. Knowing in your heart that Jesus is real because he had to show himself to his disciples. his disciples had thought within themselves because they saw how they nailed him on the cross. His disciples thought within themselves, they seen him laid, they saw them laid him in a grave. But one thing the disciples had gotten about that Jesus told them that the Son of Man must be crucified. He told them that the Son of Man must be delivered in the hands of evil men. So my brothers and sisters, I want you to know we don't have to worry about the fact, because if you know that he's real, you can tell somebody that Jesus is real. The reason we gather here this morning to let the world know that we're serving a God who's not in the grave. We serve a God who's not on the cross. We serve a God that early this morning, he got up out of the grave. And when Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to the grave looking for Jesus, the angel appeared and said, "Why look ye the living among the dead?" Anybody know real folk don't live in a graveyard? Real folks don't live in a graveyard. You must understand that Jesus began to tell them that, yes, I am real. If you believe that Jesus is real in your heart, my brothers and sisters, you ought not be ashamed to tell the world that you've been born again. So we find here as Jesus now began to appear unto his disciples. As he appeared unto the disciples, my brothers and sisters, he appeared to you and I. He appeared to us to let us know that we don't have to fear nor be discouraged. And as the disciples were just like you and I, they began hiding themselves because of fear of the Jews. I thank God this morning because deep down in my heart, I know that he's real. Somebody would ask the question, Reverend, how do you know he's real? Every now and then I can feel him moving deep down in my heart. And when I feel it moving in my heart, I know that it's nothing but the hands of the Lord. As Jesus appeared unto the disciples, he said, "Boy, I know that you are terrified. I know that you are afraid. But I want you to remember, I told you that they want to destroy this body. But I told you in 3 days, I'm going to get up out of the grave." And I want you to know that it's I, because when Jesus appeared unto the disciples, they were wondering, have they seen a spirit or they seen a ghost? See, every now and then while we're going through the troublesome time of the world, somebody asked the question, where is God? Somebody asked the question, is God real? But I stopped by to tell you, yes, he is real. And he said to the disciples, "Boys, see, look at my hands. Look at my feet." He said to them, "If you have any meat," I stopped by to tell every born again believer, you got to let the world know that he's real. When dark clouds begin to rise and when stormy wind begin to blow, you got to stand and let the world know that my God is real. And because he's real, he holds me in the hollow of his hands. Because he's real, he protects me from all hurt, harm, and danger. He said to them, "Boys, you are my disciples." It's a terrible time when we find believers don't believe that he's real. It's a crucial time when we find believers are not living up the name Jesus. But if you know that he's real, can somebody say he's real? Deep down in my soul, he said to them, "I have to let you know that I am real. Handle me and see." I stand by to tell you, if it's real in your life, when your enemy starts shooting their fiery darts at you, you tell them, "Shoot your fiery darts, because my God is real. He's going to protect me from all hurt, harm, and danger." He said to the disciples, "Boys, do you have any meat?" Every now and then, I want to paraphrase it a little. He said, "Boys, do you have any faith?" I want you to know this morning, as we gather here celebrating the resurrection Jesus, let the world know that deep down in my heart, I know that he's real. Somebody said, "Reverend, how you know he's real?" Every time I can breathe, it's nothing but life comes out of me. Every step I make, it's because he's real. Real folk can lift up holy hands. Dead folk can't breathe. Dead folk can't feel anything. But if he's real in your heart, you ought not mind letting everybody know that he is real. I believe I've reminded this morning, before bathtub now of a little boy who had a cake. And as a little boy was flying that cake up in the air, the little boy kept looking up in the sky. The man asked the little boy, he said, "Son, what are you looking at?" He said, "Sir, I have a cake up there." He said, "How do you know it's up there?" He said, "Every now and then I can feel it tugging in the air. And you want to know how do I know that he's real? Every now and then I can feel the Spirit of the Lord moving in my heart. I stop by to tell you, I know too much about him, and you can't make me doubt him. Anybody know that he's real?" Somebody say, "I know that he's real. Early this morning, he touched me with a finger of love. Allowed my golden moments to roll on just a little while longer. I'm so glad. I'm so glad." When they went to the grave, they couldn't find Jesus. I don't know about your God, but I stand by to tell you, they took Jesus, Mary, little baby, they hung him on a cross, they spit him in the side, they laid him in a grave. But early this morning, he got up out of the grave. He said, all power is in my hands. And because I know that he's real, because I know that he's real, because Jesus, he's the light of the world. If you believe that he's real, can you honk your horns to let them know that he's real? I'm so glad this morning, because he's real. I want the world to know we're not gathered this morning for form nor fashion, but we're gathered to encourage somebody. Hold on. Hold out just a little while longer. This too is going to pass. I stand by to tell you, when Jesus, Mary, little baby, appeared unto his disciples, they were troubled like you and I. They were afraid like you and I. But I'm so glad this morning, I don't have to be in fear. I'm so glad this morning, dark cloud may rise, stormy wind may blow, but I can tell the world, I found a Savior, and he's sweet. I know Jesus is real. Since I know he's real, Jesus said to the disciples, "Boys, handle me and see." Every now and then, as you journey through this COVID-19, God testing our faith. He wants us to know that he's real. I'm not worried about the coronavirus. I know that he's real. And because he's real, you got to take a bold stand for the Lord. Anybody know that God will fight your battle? God will make a way out of nowhere. When the two men on the road to Emmaus, they said to Jesus, "Are you the only stranger in town? Have you heard what they did to Jesus? They took our priest. They had him over to the sinful man. They crucified him. But they said, this is the third day. And he told us on the third day, he's going to get up out of the grave. And some of our associates went to the grave, but they couldn't find him there." Anybody know that he's not dead? Anybody know that he's not dead? If you know that he's not dead, can you honk your horn one more time to let the world know? I'm glad. I'm so glad that he is real. Jesus is real. My brothers and sisters, you don't have to worry about what's going on around us. We serve a God who's able to fight our battle. The same Jesus who appeared to his disciples, he's appearing to you and I to let us know that he is real. Does not mean that storm won't come our way. Does not mean that we won't be trialed. Does not mean that temptation doesn't appear. Does not mean that your enemy won't come up against you. But what it does mean, since he is real, he's going to protect you. He's going to hold you in the hollow of his hands. So I want you to remind for one more time, the disciples were hiding in the fear of the Jews, but he is real. And because he really told the disciples, "Boy, why are you troubled? Handle me and see." And I want to say to you this morning, I thank God for each and every one of you. Remember, my prayer is that this message has encouraged you to hold on just a little while longer. This too is going to pass. Let us pray. Father God, it's again that we approach your throne. thanking you for letting us know that you are real. Thank you for being real in our lives. Thank you, God, for being real in our hearts. And God, since we experienced the resurrection of Jesus, now let us become a city that's set upon a hill, which cannot be hidden. Let men, women, boys, and girls know that Jesus is real. We want to thank you for allowing us to gather one more time. We ask now, God, Spirit of a living God, fall fresh upon us. Hold us, Master, in the hollow of your hands. If we said or thought anything that were not like you, we ask now, would you cast in a sea of forgiveness, won't rise and walk condemn us. And we ask you now that these and many more blessings be accepted in Jesus' name, we pray. I certainly want to say to all of you out there, social media, to Facebook page, remember that you read the scripture for yourself. As Jesus told the disciples, handle me and see the rest. Spirit has no flesh. If you read on down in that same passage of scripture, when he was blessing his disciples, and he disappeared, he sent them a commission to go and preach the resurrection Jesus. Again, he is real. God bless each and every one of you. May God keep you. May God's Spirit continue to be upon you. Continue to be strong. Amen.